is another vice. Another vice is another vice. Another vice. Another vice. Another
being here. Funkhauser sitting next to you on another episode, and today we're going to talk to a band called Midnight North. But first, I'll tell you.
Are these times contagious?
Oh yeah, it's a good one. Collective Soul. That there. Here's a list of 7 things you should never say to your female coworker. Oh, you're ready for this list? Here we go. Number 7, you should wear more makeup. Number 6, why do you always look so angry? Number 5. Are you on your period? Number 4. Are you dating anyone? Well. Number 3. Did you gain or lose weight? I think, did you gain weight or did you lose weight? I think you should ask that one. Did you gain or lose weight? Number 2. You're bossy. Oh, you're bossy. Number 1, you should smile more. Where I agree with the number 1 there, but that's about it. Don't tell people to smile, though. They don't like it. just do yourself a favor and smile. Don't say any of those things I just said to females at work. Say other things like, hello, how are you? Here's the thing you wanted. I'll be back to ask you for coffee later.
Is there a cure among us?
Tequila. same songs in my car. Maybe a memory, it only hits me this hard. When I taste tequila, baby, I still see a sorority t-shirt, the same one you wore when we were.
Mistakes, and I couldn't take them back, and I've been running around in circles till I'm dizzy, I can't lie, but every night I go to sleep's a day that I survive. I'm not afraid of getting older, I'm one less day from dying young. I see the light go past my shoulder, I'm one less day from dying young, and I've seen friends fall away before their time, and I've been afraid that I may follow in their light. So I drink and love and whisper all the things I know are right. Someday I will leave this world, but maybe not tonight. I'm not afraid of getting older, I'm one less day from dying young. And I see the lights go past my shoulder, from dying young. I'm one less day from dying young. All my life I have been wandering, burning up my candle like my time just won't end. And I'll keep burning till there's nothing left, praying that tomorrow I can do it all again. And if I get tomorrow, I will do it all again. I'm not afraid getting older, I'm one less day from dying young. And I see the light go past my shoulder, I'm one less day from dying young. I'm not afraid of getting older, I'm one less day from dying young. I see the light go past my shoulder,
so just to let you know, the Funk Owls are sitting next to you. Show is brought to you by True Value. Come on to Miller True Value for the automotive supplies you need to keep your car or truck running smoothly this season. Yeah. Like your choice of Pennzoil, motor oil. Right now, like I said, a quart is only $2.99 while supplies last all this month. Stock up today and keep your car going the extra mile or your truck. Woo! Miller True Value. Behind every project is a true value. So this is Midnight North, okay? Pretty good band. Pretty nice sound. We're going to talk to him in a little bit here on Funkhauser sitting next to you today. Midnight North.
When did you realize I had such dark eyes that might be sparkling just for you? I found out your street was caffeinated across. I'm just trying to see things like you do.
So if you're just joining us, here, this is Graham from Midnight North, and for some reason, he's a West Coaster on the East Coast playing music for a while with a really great band called Midnight North, and there's a video out that you should see, and the link is below here on whatever you're listening to. There's a link there. Do you listen to podcasts, Graham?
I do. Yeah.
Do you know, can you give us a suggestion?
I listen to a lot of weird, nerdy sports podcasts, personally. But then, you know, also the mainstay is another thing.
Well, throw me the one that you can't get enough of. That's what I'm after. Even if it is a nerdy sports cast, we could take it.
Anyone who's a baseball fan, listen to Effectively Wild on Fangraph.
Okay, Effectively Wild. All right.
Yeah.
That's the thing that blings your phone. Blink! There's a new episode available for that.
Yep, exactly.
Cool, man. Okay, so let's talk about bands that influenced you for a second. Like, maybe not the whole band, but you in general. You said you were in another band before this. Where do you stand musically?
Well, I mean, what's cool about Midnight North is that it is a cool, you know, blend of all of our influences. My dad is a musician, and I play in a band with him as well. He was in the Grateful Dead, so that's obviously a pretty big influence.
There's a plus. Okay, so there's your influence. Uh-huh. All right.
Oh, that's one, though. You know, like, that's not going to be the only one. You know, we, as a band, Midnight North sort of gravitated. Elliot and I started, you know, when we'd cover songs, it'd be like Graham Parsons and Emmylou Harris songs and, you know, classic country tunes and stuff like that. And, you know, we love the music of the band, Levon Helm, and how, you know, all of that.
Wait a minute. Does your dad live in the Bay Area, too? Was he a hippie?
Yeah, I'd say so, yeah.
The Grateful Dead. Okay. What's happening here? Are there hippies on the East Coast now, too? Or do they just...
There are hippies everywhere, man.
Yeah.
We're everywhere.
I see. We're everywhere. Good.
Yeah.
I seem to not find so many down here in Los Angeles. I was just talking to a metal band, and we were talking about how the Sunset Strip has changed so much, where you can't even really see a time where it was like run by rock music, you know. And it was way before our time. It's like when we were kids,
exactly.
We probably visited.
All that stuff definitely changes, but you know, we get our little enclaves of the music that we like, and we like to keep going. I don't know. It's all connected. You asked about influences. I mean, we're on the East Coast, for Brooklyn Comes Alive. We're going to do another, Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young sort of tribute. Cause we, you know, we love singing those harmonies, and, that's another big influence on us. And, you know, that's from LA, that's from Laurel Canyon. They're kind of hippies too, but, you know, a different kind. They're not jamming as much. And that's, you know, that's something we like to focus on as well. We can jam, Midnight North can, but I'm sure just from listening to stuff like the Highway Song and some of our other material that you might have checked out, that's not really our focus, at least in more recording music.
Sure, yeah. I mean, it's all about coming together with intention, with well-trained harmonies. And who's, are you writing this? You said you're writing half of it, and the lead singer, what's her name? Was
Elliot Peck.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you listen to our music, I mean, I'm the lead singer on about half of it. She's the lead singer on most of the rest. The rest of the band is Alex Jordan on organ and guitar, and he's the third harmony vocal most of the time. And Connor O'Sullivan on bass. And we kind of all shape the songs once the skeletons have been written, you know, the lyrics and the melody and the chords.
Right.
You know, Elliot or I will bring something to the band, and we'll work out the rest and see how it fits in like an electric format.
Wow.
And see what sort of harmonies we can come up with. Yeah.
You see, I'm sure you don't need it. You have 1,000 songs already, but is a cover band, a cover album in the works? Do you ever, not in the works, but do you guys ever play cover songs and stuff?
We play tons of covers. Like I mentioned just a few minutes ago, we do some, you know, sort of tribute shows is a strong term, but, you know, a set of all, you know, one band or the other's songs. We've done a CSMY.
I'd buy that if you released it.
Or two.
Somebody should get a video camera out there and illegally record it and pirate it and put it on YouTube so we can see it. Because I'll tell you what, I would like to see that. So you guys...
I believe there are a few videos out there. We have no problem with people. If the venue's okay with it, we have no problem. Following in the Grateful Dead tradition, once we're done playing with it, we're done with it. It's out there for the world. So.
And I wonder if you're going to have bootleggers like they did, you know?
You never know. We try and the important thing for that is just to keep the music fresh, so people want to come back each show, and they don't mind if it's the same, they're seeing the same band for two nights in a row. We want to keep it fresh and interesting for them. So, you know, for that, we do play a lot of covers. CSMY, we've done a whole tribute set to the band. We hire a big horn section and do those Alan Toussaint arrangements as best we can. And the bands that sort of inspire us, we've done Graham Parsons and Cosmic Americana set. We've got a lot of influences, and we're not afraid to throw them out. We like to, you know, give them our own twist, though. You know, maybe it's if we do a Grateful Dead song, maybe it's we have Elliot sing it, so it's not too much of a cover band sort of act. We're doing our own thing with it. We're changing the key. We're adding harmonies where there weren't before. So, you know, when we work up a cover, it's something different. And if you do want to listen to some,
I'm going to go on a search, man.
You can search YouTube for Midnight North, and there will be plenty of our recordings.
Your bootleg material,
songs,
sure.
CSMY songs.
Bootleggers unite.
I don't know if we've ever thought about putting out a record, but maybe a live record or something.
One of these days. I think you should. Okay, so being a band, being Midnight North on the East Coast, I assume that you're sharing a vehicle together and cruising the Eastern Seaboard. And while we are all together,
from the video, actually.
Oh, really? Did you film a lot of that while you were driving around?
That's all filmed near home. It's meant to evoke anywhere. But my buddy Will Agee, an awesome documentary filmmaker, directed that.
It's really good, man.
It sort of feel like anywhere California or anywhere USA, but it's all sort of nearby home in California. And it's cool to recognize some of the spots.
Well, besides Highway Song, which is near and dear to my heart, I was going to ask you, like, we are driving around together on this show, and we're coming up with recommendations as to, like, what kind of driving songs we could be listening to. And, you know, I wasn't going to ask you this question because I was just going to go out with the Highway Song because it makes sense. You know, we're going to be on that thing. So.
Yeah.
But, you know, now that you do all these covers and you're into all the classics, is there something that you can recommend? An obscure song that people might not know that could be like a good cruising song. Like if you guys are out there on the Eastern Seaboard cranking music, has anything crossed your audio palette?
That's a really good question. It sort of changes. I've been listening to a lot of sort of the newer Nashville guys who aren't doing, they're not doing pop country so much. They,
like Sturgill Simpson. Do you know Sturgill
Simpson? I love Sturgill.
Okay.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Anderson East and Chris Stapleton and guys like that. We're actually lucky enough. We're going to play a show with him at Levon Helm's barn in Woodstock in a few weeks. A guy named Hayes Carl, an amazing Nashville singer-songwriter. And he's got a song called Bad Liver and a Broken Heart.
Oh, man.
It's like the perfect country rock song.
I'm going to play it. I'm going to play it.
Yep. Do it. I love that song. It's a good driving song. That's just sort of the one that popped into my head when you asked that question. So,
Well, Graham from Midnight North, thank you for the time. Thank you for being sitting next to us here on the show. We will see you back when you're in a 4-hour drive from me instead of a 40-hour drive, and enjoy the tour and, you know, do all the things, man.
That's the plan.
Looked away. Free.
before we get out of here, I got to hear that Hayes Carl song. Here's Bad Liver and a Broken Heart by request.
Say, you know the love is blind. I'm about to see. I close my eyes. They can't see you in it all. Most of them need dollar signs to make every day your birthday and every night your Valentine.
If we tried that, we could be somewhere. The climate
when I'm this hard for sure. It's like I'm not dead. Get this off my chest. I think I know I love you. I swear yo, the best. Been in all day. Get this off my chest. Oh yeah, I think I love you. Oh baby, maybe we try that we could be somewhere.
Never grow. Some people don't know when to quit, and that's why they quit. Some need to hit the bottom to see they got a problem. They can't handle it, but that ain't why I started cleaning up my life. Wish it was, but ooh, that would be a lie. I've been sober, 'cause there ain't no hangover like you, girl. No, 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 baby, can you come over? I always find those words at the bottom of a 100 proof, yeah. Girl, every time you do, I just stand up and all messed up like the sheets where we made love. I've been sober since you broke my heart in two, 'cause drunk me can't get over you.
No hangover like you.
Can't get over, can't get over.
There ain't no hangover like you.
No, no, no. All those bottles sitting up on the shelf are just salt on the wound. One sip and I'm picking up the phone, trying not to go home without you. And that ain't nothing but a whole lot of pain. And that kinda hurts.
To play along. secrets in this life that I can't hide. Well, somewhere in this darkness there's a light that I can't find. Well, maybe it's too far away, yeah. Or maybe I'm just blind. Maybe I'm just blind. So hold me when I'm here, love me when I'm wrong. See under my skin. I won't tell you a damn thing that I could not tell my friends. Roaming through this darkness, I'm alive, but I'm alone. And part of me is fighting